This building at East 18th Street and Locust has always been somewhat of an eyesore before and after the collapse. But two Metro men called it home. What they didn't know is, according to Casey's Planning and Development Department, there were no permits allowing them to live there, nor for the construction that they heard and saw all around them. Kansas City's Crossroads District is always changing, always moving, always artistic. Old buildings turn new and new businesses embracing the old. A perfect space for the young and creative.
I found this apartment on Craigslist. It was just advertised like any other apartment in the housing wanted section.
Michael Crilly loved the character in the loft at 18th and Locust.
I was actually the first one to see it, and there was 9 appointments lined up, so I just went ahead and got it right on the spot.
He told his friend Connor McGuire about the second unit.
I wanted to make that place my home. You know, I've lived in Kansas City for 2 years and I've moved around quite a few times, and I thought that I was ready to invest in that place.
The men thought they found their home in a prime location in the center of the crossroads. Jackson County sale records show a company called 500 East 18th Street LLC bought the building at the end of March. Missouri state records show the building is owned by construction lawyer Jody Gondring, with Mark K. Abbott listed as its registered agent. The website for Abbott Properties shows the company is involved in many projects across the crossroads, from new to old and in between. Abbott Properties, headed by primary partner Matt Abbott, seemed to have a solid foundation in the city. And then this happened. On the morning of October 6th, the floor fell out of Connor's apartment.
I just feel very gracious to be alive.
Both Connor and Michael were out of town. Michael woke up to a voicemail.
Hi, Michael. This is Ryan with Abbott Properties. Just giving you a call. We have a situation at your building.
Connor woke up to people wondering if he was alive.
This was my wall.
Artist Oliver Wright painted his mural on the building just 3 weeks before the collapse.
It was a little heartbreaking, you know. It's like after you put a labor of love into something like a mural of this size. They don't know for sure what happened, but I think with all the rain that happened and the construction, it just created the perfect storm.
The building was nearly 100 years old, and tenants say work crews were making changes.
When I moved in, it was quiet. There wasn't really a lot going on. But over the first month, there started to definitely be construction. I noticed a lot of people in and out of the building downstairs and upstairs.
I saw there was a big dumpster in the lower level. They had the garage door open, and they had a bobcat in there. I don't know exactly what they were doing, but they were obviously loading dirt or something.
Crilly says most days crews were in the building and saw them replacing electrical and adding new heating and air conditioning. All things you need city permits for. Fox 4 problem solvers checked with Kansas City's Planning and Development Department, which had no approved permits. It did find one denied permit. An examiner for the city tells problem solvers a company called Crossroads East, also owned by Gondring, applied for a permit near the end of September. The name on the permit, Craig Donnell, who's listed as the head electrician on Abbott Properties' website. The application indicated it was for electrical work on a project called the Galleria, to put individually metered electrical units in the building. The city denied it. The examiner says while the building is zoned for residential use, the company had no permit to let anyone live there. A company would need both, and that means Connor and Michael should not have been living there.
Yeah, I was just surprised, honestly. You know, it was never brought up during the application process, and just surprised to find out that they didn't have the permit in place for us to be living here.
Both men say they rented their apartments through 500 East 18th Street LLC, and their electricity costs were included in the rent. After the collapse, both men are staying with friends and family and say Abbott Properties hasn't been much help.
They tried to cash my rent check for the month.
Fox 4 reached out to Abbott Properties and Jody Gondring. After scheduling an interview with the property company, they rescheduled and then canceled when we declined to provide them our questions ahead of time. We reached out again for an interview, but Abbott Properties formally declined.
I definitely don't have a bed. That's definitely gone. But I have myself. Every time I start to get sad, I just remember that I have myself. And that's what's important.
They also say while an apartment or loft might seem cool, in the future they'll take the extra effort to make sure it's legal.
It may be an awesome location, it may have a ton of character, but you know, things like these apparently do happen. So just think twice when you're thinking about renting an older building.
The men have filed a complaint with the city, and the city is looking into it. And if they do find that a violation occurred, they could be facing a fine. Sheree Honeycutt, Fox 4 News.